Nice to see you
Good morning,
again.
good morning. And see you.
After our meeting in Frankfurt, thank you very much for being here, participating in our event. And I really hope that next time you will join us in person rather than through Skype.
Very kind.
Let's start by hearing your views on the general context and future developments of reporting non-financial data, as well as to the link with sustainable finance, and also the importance of the sustainability code as a practical tool for reporting non-financial data, which also combines all international standards for reporting.
Okay. Well, firstly, thank you to you and to everyone at the conference. I met you personally only earlier this week, as you say, but I've had contact with the Greek Sustainability Code over some years. I admire and support the work that you're doing in Greece. I got to know you in my former role as a member of the European Parliament when I was responsible for the European Union's non-financial reporting directive, and I will say some words about that in a moment. But also I have to say it was the Greek presidency of the European Union, the government in the country, that played a crucial role in getting European agreement of that directive, and I was working directly with them. And so I'm really honoured and pleased to be addressing this conference. We have a number of, I'm now of course the Chief Executive of the International Integrated Reporting Council. This is the global coalition which is bringing together codes, network frameworks like yours with businesses, with investors worldwide to genuinely integrate financial and non-financial reporting. And I'm delighted, I see you as a partner, and I see this opportunity to address this conference as strengthening that partnership. I know there will be some in the room, like Coca-Cola Hellenic Bottling Company, like the Titan Group, the Building Materials Group, that I think are probably in the audience there, that are already undertaking integrated reporting in Greece. Thank you for your commitment. But there are other globes there like Lafarge, like TNT, that are on the journey towards this internationally. But I'm also aware that many of the companies that you've got there are smaller or medium-sized Greek-based companies, not necessarily multinational companies, and that this is an opportunity for you to be aware of this global movement towards integrating financial and non-financial reporting. And I thank you for giving time to today. I know that the Greek economy has suffered in recent years, but I know also that the commitment of those behind the sustainability code in Greece is that this does improve the competitiveness of companies and of your economy, and I want to very much support that aim. Next, let me say a little bit about the importance of collaboration in this. There isn't a single answer to these big challenges that we're seeing in the world. There are many different initiatives, frameworks that are helping businesses adapt to the new realities. Climate change, of course, but other big global trends like mass migration, like the whole moves towards digitalization and cybersecurity. These are big things that are transforming markets and transforming business. And of course, markets are changing internationally too. The growth of the BRICS companies, countries, the internationalization that's taking place, which means that companies aren't standing still and constantly have to have a wider, broader view of the markets in which they're operating, of the relationship between the financial returns to the company and those relationships, which are financial themselves. They have an impact on the long-term value creation of the company, and the financial impact may not be in 3 months' time, but definitely does have an impact on the sustainability of business, not just the sustainability of the planet. So that's very much the philosophy behind what we're all doing. And then collaboration is the key. If you look at the Greek Sustainability Code and the International Integrated Reporting Framework, the overall umbrella, you'll see that there are so many things in common between us. And I know the Greek code came from the German code. It's such a good example about how collaboration works. But the idea that we should have strategy, the idea that this should be forward-looking, the idea that there should be connectedness between the different aspects of what the company is doing in its markets, these are all common aspects that aren't just in the Greek Sustainability Code, but are in others as well. And I very much embrace that, and particularly that it brings together, integrates financial and non-financial. So some of the elements in the metrics of the Greek Sustainability Code and the German Code come from the financial reporting world. Some of them come from the sustainability reporting world, but they are distilled down into an initiative which we hope and you hope is helpful to us and advances us there. And what I want to say at the international level is that we are working with yourselves in Greece and all of these other initiatives to try and align worldwide. This is part of a global movement, a global coalition. We run something called the Global Corporate Reporting Dialogue, which inch by inch is bringing all of these different frameworks together. Already we have a common mapping exercise. Already we have a common definition of materiality, a really crucial aspect. This has to be material to the business and its future, not just to wider society. We've got a common approach on that. We're developing a common approach on the sustainable development goals of the United Nations. And I want you to be part of that. And I want companies in Greece that are going down this road to have confidence that this is a direction of travel that is the future. This is the future of corporate reporting. And because I know that I'm speaking via Skype, you've got a busy conference today. I hope this is being heard and is clear to you. The last thing I want to talk about is the EU's non-financial reporting directive, something that I was responsible for in the European Parliament in getting agreed. And I'm now so proud to be helping in a different role with its implementation. And I think many of the companies in the room today will be aware that there are changed reporting requirements from the European level. And I want to say that you shouldn't fear that. You shouldn't see it as a cost. You shouldn't see it as a burden. This is not about more reporting. It's about better reporting. And it's also about having a principles-based approach. So no company in this room needs to fear that if you don't do something by this time next year, you're going to end up in court or fined or criticised. That shouldn't be the spirit of this. The spirit, and I help get it agreed, the spirit is that this is about making reporting better and giving more freedom for companies to have long-term vision, to look forward, to understand the relationship with the wider world. And therefore, if you look into both the directive, which is transposed into Greek law, and also into the guidelines that the European Commission has published recently, all of the same principles that I referred to earlier between the philosophy of integrated reporting and the philosophy of the Greek Sustainability Code, you will find in those guidelines. These are not separate or different things. And so, for example, the commitment to including the business model, that commitment to strategy, the commitment to connectivity, and of course, the underlying commitment that we all have to the principle of sustainable development. Now, I know some of the words are difficult either for people in the room or perhaps when you go back and report this to some of your colleagues. And therefore, the people at the front of the room are there to assist. And at the global level, we are there to assist. But what I see is a historic moment for us in Europe. We're a global body, but I'm someone who has a European background. And what we know is that 6,000 companies of the largest companies in Europe because of the non-financial reporting directive, are between this year and next year changing their reporting. Changing their reporting for the better. Better for the business, I want to underline. But because you're considering how to change that reporting, I want you to really consider making sure it is integrated reporting, financial and non-financial together. That is what we intended in the European Union. It's what all our colleagues in QualityNet and in the Greek Sustainability Code, that's what they want to see. I think it's what this conference is intended to promote. And as having the honour to be an international speaker, even remotely, it's what I want to encourage. Thank you so much for listening to me. I hope many of you will have contact directly with IIRC, the International Integrated Reporting Council. I hope that you will also support building the friendship and the partnership that we have with our friends in the Greek Sustainability Code. Thank you very much for listening to me.
Richard, thank you very much. And I keep from your speech 2 points, materiality and quality of data, in order the reporting non-financial data to take the added value that the business needs to have according to the next directives about sustainable finance. And this is very important for Greek businesses.
Indeed, and the thing I want to underline, you and I know this together, but to your full audience, is that don't be frightened that this is going to involve a lot of extra metrics, a lot of extra paperwork. You know, if this becomes just a box-ticking exercise, then it takes away from that spirit. Yes, we do need to understand better the impact of the natural environment, of people, of human capital, of society, of social capital, as we call it. In integrated reporting, we talk about the 6 capitals, financial and manufactured, of course, but human, social and relationship, natural capital, and intellectual capital, ideas. All of these do have an impact, but it's not saying that you have to have dozens of new metrics for each of those and a huge workload to produce them. That's not what we're saying. You make the judgments about that, what is really material to you as a company. And the Greek Sustainability Code, being an example of integrated reporting, is pretty short and gives a really good guide and helping hand for you to be able to do that. And I hope the integrated reporting framework is consistent with that. You see that, I see that, and that you will begin to just referring to it. But it's very non-prescriptive. It's not that you're going to be caught out and a whistle blown if you don't do it. It's about helping you to do something that in the end is in the interests of your business.
Thank you, Richard. It was our honor to have you with us. See you again.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
I hope soon. Thank you.